Hi, and welcome to Bill's World. I hope you're getting here because the next few episodes of Bill's World will be focusing on the world of video games. That's right, video games. First up in our topic of the world of video games is Nintendo. Let's take a look back at its success as we go back in time. Man, we're in the year 1983, that's the year of the great North American video game crash, when the failure of Atari's E.T. and Pac-Man were the main causes behind the demands failing to be met in the video game crash. A lot of consoles were put planned and were eventually discontinued. Soon enough, new competitors would come in and rise from the ashes and enter the video game industry. One of those competitors was a little company from Japan, operated by Miyamoto, named Nintendo. Nintendo entered the video industry in Japan with Pong consoles that were only made for Japan televisions. No point there, a plane that here in America. In fact, they also began experimenting with the Game Watch games, as Miyamoto saw a guy playing with his calculator on a train ride and created the world's first pocket-sized handheld video games. Just as the video game crash in 1983 was winding down, the Nintendo NES was born. Also known as the Nintendo Entertainment System, or known in Japan as the Famicom, or Famicom Computer. This was a video game console to make a big impact on Nintendo. It has lots of very cool games. A simple controller wired in. That's hardwired. It came with this little fella, Rob, made to play with two games, John Ray and Stack Up, in the black boxes. Yeah, I'll explain that later. There was even the NES Advantage, an arcade-style controller, one of the many accessories for your NES. Which I don't have time to explain them all, but, you know, now let's get to the games. If you have these games in a black box, you know they're classic masterpieces. A work of art with these NES games. You want to know what the cartridge looks like. Well, that's coming up in just a few seconds. But man, those black boxes sure are classy. Cartridges look like this. Like a video cassette. It also looked like this in Japan, where it's called the Famicom. There were even some unlicensed games, which I do not have time to show. Anyway, let's get going with what else they have to offer. What is the Super NES, the N64, Virtual Boy, Game Boy, the DS, the GameCube, the Wii, Wii U, and Switch. Those are the other video game consoles, which I'm giving you a quick rundown through, because I don't have enough time to show it to you. And speaking of time, I'm out of time. Well, in our next episode, we're going to be talking about the world of Atari. Don't miss it. See you next time.